Hi all, we are Team Happy Sounds. This is Isham, who is the front-end developer, Yusan, who is the back-end developer, Chiang, who is the lead QA, and I am Sulogna, who is the PM. Our clients for Kerozil, a Singapore-based online marketplace, which focuses towards giving users a good selling experience by listing the products, by taking pictures of the products and then listing them. We helped Kerozil to develop a web platform. We basically catered to the needs of the people who wanted a better browsing experience on a bigger screen and also had difficulty with managing their office on a small screen.
What made us choose this project? So it's very different because when Kerozil first approached us, normally usually huge sites will usually move from a web platform to a mobile platform. But Kerozil first started out as a mobile platform, so we're all very interested. So why is Kerozil asking us to move from mobile to web? That's like counterintuitive from what we usually know. But we started going more in-depth and realized that actually retail is actually done more on web, and it seems more logical to us now as users. So what happens is that we decided to say that's a very interesting problem. I don't think anyone has really done mobiles on web before. And so we decided to take this up. So, and plus we also care about users ourselves, so we kind of wanted it too.
So moving on to the challenges faced, mainly it is designing the whole user experience. It was actually very tedious. Kerozil is not exactly Amazon, it's not eBay either, and it's kind of like almost like Gumtree, but then there's more social aspect to it. So what our sponsors wanted was for us to like actually go through a lot of different marketplace designs. So we actually had to look at things like Etsy, Pinterest, Vinted, basically all the different types of marketplaces, and then we actually studied each UX flow. So for instance, like the login sign up flow, our product page, the user profile page, and then we will actually collate all of these things, come up with our design, and then propose to our sponsors who will respond to us and then iterate through that again. So it was actually quite tedious. Yeah, and we had to go through a lot of iterations of that. So apart from that, technological challenges faced would be actually integrating AngularJS and Flask. So the first major problem was that their templating actually clashes. Both of them use the double curly braces, so that was a bit
awkward.
Yeah, it was actually a really big problem that we had to handle. And then apart from that, other challenges faced would actually just be how the learning curve of AngularJS is actually quite steep, as Isham here will tell you. And I don't know, apart from that, actually learning Kerozil's backend architecture, everything, we had to understand how everything works. So the messaging, I mean like queuing, and then how the workers handle the task, everything. We had to actually understand all of that in order for us to implement the backend APIs. So yeah, that's about.
For more, just see our architectural diagram. It scares me.
So firstly, we want to thank our FYP supervisor, which is Prof Rengan, for his valuable advice throughout this course of our project. So secondly, we want to thank our sponsors, which is Kerozil. So they are the three co-founders, which is Suri, Marcus, and Lucas. And we also want to thank our Kerozil lead engineer, which is Victor, for his advice and help throughout our project. And lastly, we want to thank Toku Studios for the best user experience award.